What's up, guys? I'm back after the tribute meet. If you guys saw anything on Instagram or on YouTube, you know it didn't go anywhere close to what I'd hoped. But that's how things go sometimes, and I gotta say, I'm honestly not too surprised. This meet prep ended up, you know, even though I went in being excited, enthusiastic about it, having fun, ended up being just as challenging as all my other meet preps, so I made a lot of mistakes. I think I learned a lot. I am glad that I went ahead and did the meet, even knowing that I had injury risks, injury issues that I was dealing with, and that there were no guarantees that I would be able to perform at all, and I wasn't. So I want to recap some of this meet, the decision to compete at all, what went wrong, why I followed through anyway, and where I'm going next. And rather than just show you a picture of my talking head, we're going to look at some of the highs and lows of this past meet prep as I kind of explain things. So going into the meet, I decided to go 181. And I did that because I thought there were a lot of opportunities at 181 that I wouldn't have at 198. And because after cutting to about 193 for the US Open, I was within shooting distance of 181, which wasn't somewhere that I had ever planned to be again. And it's not somewhere we'll ever be again. I think that was a good decision. There were a lot of really big, audacious goals, grand goals, that I had at 181. I wanted to squat 800, deadlift 800, and total 2,000. And honestly, had I stayed healthy, I think that those would have been a reality. But I didn't stay healthy. This is the rep where I injured myself at the very bottom. I felt something pop in my upper quad, and honestly, that derailed my entire meet prep. That was about a month out of the meet. Very difficult to recover from. And at that point, right there, right where you're watching, I thought my meet prep was over. It wasn't that painful. I was lying on the ground because I thought I was done. Now, I don't think I got injured because I was being stupid. This was exactly the right weight to take. This was my planned opener 4 weeks out. But I think that I had been dieting so hard for so long, and I was so lean that I was just predisposed to more injuries from training heavy so often. And, you know, that's my own fault. I overestimated my abilities, and I paid the price for it. So my coach, Jacob and Dominic, they kind of talked me off the ledge, and Stacy gave me a lot of support, and I decided, okay, I'm going to try and do this prep. I'm going to try and continue as best as I possibly can. This is about 2 weeks later. I'm able to squat again, but you can see I can't get anywhere near depth, and this is a super lightweight in reps, so it's looking quiet for your boy. I can't get my hips in position for deadlift, right? So I can deadlift without pain, but I can't get my hips in the right position, and so I can't pull for shit. And so, you know, it was a disaster mentally for me. It was just so disappointing. And that's why I haven't been posting a lot on YouTube, and I've been posting a lot of throwback stuff on Instagram. I just didn't have the heart to post anything more than that. Even as the quad got better enough that I could get my hips in position for deadlift, the strength just wasn't there. And you can see it. This is a 650 deadlift attempt. This should be nothing. Nothing. I should be able to triple this at least. And it doesn't go well. And man, I collapsed. And my coach, Jacob, he was at that workout, and you know, I just kind of stormed out of the gym after that rep, and I feel bad. You know, I think I jeopardized the relationship to some degree by letting my emotions get the better of me. And that's not the person I want to be, and that's not how I want any of my training to go. Meet prep, no matter what's on the line, you know, it's just not worth that. So Jake and I work things out, and Stacy's always been there to support me. And so I was able, actually, to get back on track after this rep. I was like, look, man, you got to make some changes. You got to back off. You can't keep pushing. You're injured. You gotta let your body recover. You can see my hips are still a little bit too far back there. So I do that. You know, at this point, we're about 2 weeks out of the meet. So things are... It's looking grim. It's looking like I'm going to have to drop out. And I contact the meet director at that point, and I tell him, you know, look, man, I'm doing my absolute best. I do not want to drop out of this meet. It means so much to me. You know, Pioneer was sponsoring the meet. I think Pioneer is the best company in the industry. I wanted to show up, and I wanted to do something big to make them proud, make Matt Hayden proud, and the other people, the other great people involved in that company. So I was really disappointed, but I was going to give it my all. And so you can see, these light squats were a lot better than those other ones. I'm actually able to hit depth for once in this month of disastrous training. And from there, things start to slowly start to creep back to the way they should be. And, you know, my deadlifts start going a little bit better. And the very last heavy training session that I had scheduled, I nailed it. I hit exactly what I was supposed to hit had I never gotten injured in the first place. And man, I almost cried after that workout. I was like, I cannot believe I did this. Cannot believe it. And all of a sudden, I'm like, we're back in the game. I got this. I'm going to do all this stuff. I couldn't believe it. So then I go in the Monday after for my regular workout before the meet, which is I take my planned opener on squat and bench squat and bench for three singles each. And on the third single of the squat, I feel my hamstring pull. And I'm just like equally disappointed again, right? Like, I just can't believe it. The roller coaster of this prep has just been absolutely absurd. And again, I'm sure it was because I was dieting for so long. I was so lean. I was just, my body was exhausted. I was pushing it through too much. I was asking too much of my body. So, you know, at that point, we were 4 days out of the meet or something like that. I decide, like, look, let's just see where we're at. I knew I'd have to go through that cut with no guarantees that I'd be able to lift at all. And I wasn't able to lift. When I was warming up for squats, I could feel, it actually wasn't my hamstring, I think it was an adductor, but I could feel that once I got to 400, I could feel it. Once I got to 500, it was bad. And I could tell if I tried anything remotely competitive on squat, that sucker was just gone. Like, I had to end up in the hospital. So I played it smart at that point, finally, right? I decided, look, I'll just take a token squat. I tried to bench to just to keep my head in the game. My thought was, hey, look, I could pull with the quad. Maybe I can still pull with the quad, but maybe I can pull with the hamstring too. And I could deadlift without pain, but again, I couldn't get my hips in the right position. Couldn't break up the bar at the floor the right way, and 800 just wasn't going to happen. Nothing was going to happen even remotely impressive on deadlift. So I took an opener there and called it. And, you know, obviously that was incredibly disappointing after all I had pushed myself through a meet prep and how badly I wanted it. But that's how it goes sometimes. That's part of the sport. And I accepted that when I signed up for the meet. I accepted that when I decided I was going to focus on powerlifting as my career. And so I'm okay with that. I'm looking forward to the future, actually. Instead of dwelling on the past, which is a really big step for me personally. So I'm glad I was somehow able to do that. I think I really honestly just got over my disappointment earlier in the training cycle when I was hurt all the time. But, you know, I can still train. I don't think I could go over like 80% this week or maybe even next week, but I can at least still train, right? Like, I'm going to get in the gym tomorrow and I'm going to do some light pulls and then some light squats maybe later in the week, and then we'll probably be back to normal. Which brings me to my plans for the future, which is obviously never again going 181. That is not going to happen. I'm going up to 220. I'm going to compete, well, 220 pounds of the off season. I'm going to compete at 198. I'm going to actually eat for the first time in fucking 20 weeks. It's going to be incredible. And I'm really looking forward to putting my size back on, putting my strength back on too. Man, I was excited for this workout. So that's the plan there. I'm going to actually start training with Chris Duffin and Brandon Sen of Kabuki. They're going to help me with my training, with my planning for the future. And I'm doing that, you know, as much as I love to do that for myself, I think I've gotten so mentally overwhelmed in the past preps that I need to hand it off to somebody else. I need to put my trust on someone else, someone who's already achieved a ton in the sport, has coached a lot of high-level lifters, which Brandon and Chris have both done, and I need to let them take care of things and just do my job of lifting heavy-ass shit. So that's the plan. I'm pretty psyched for it. You know, things didn't go my way, but that's okay. They're not always going to go your way. And there's always next time. So we're making a long-term plan. We're going to execute on that plan. We're going to enjoy training again. And I can't wait. I'm also really going to step up the content production. So I'm hoping to do a lot more with Pioneer, and including doing some new wrap explanation videos, some reviews of their new Pioneer Cut belt, which I freaking love. I don't get any free shit from Pioneer, so please don't think that I'm trying to advertise them and just push them on you. I truly believe in Matt and what he does for the sport and the quality of his product. So go snag one of these awesome hats before they're sold out. I also have one other thing I want to talk about. I have a somewhat new program coming out. It's actually just an example of what you can do with Unfuck Your Program. It's a 6-week off-season plan. It's pretty darn complicated. If you've tried my intermediate program, my beginner program, or UIP, or any of my other stuff, you know I usually play it simple, but it doesn't have to be that way. And I think a lot of people have kind of misunderstood my philosophy. So this off-season program, for this first week, when it's launching, you can grab it for $5. And I just want to do that to make it accessible to as many people as possible so that you can see, hey, look, the right way to do this is to design your own program. You know, you want to make something that works for you, not something that works for somebody else. But that doesn't mean it needs to be exactly in my style. It can be as complicated, as simple, as intense, as relaxed as you want it to be. And so I encourage you to check that out. I'm going to put the link in the description below. Until then, thanks for watching. Expect a lot more videos from me and Kyle. And make sure to think strong and train hard.